Like, there's no reason to have lumps like that on her neck. But she went to a horse doctor, so she gets what she gets. Marcia, are you listening to me?
Mm-hmm.
What are you doing?
Reading the menu.
I see that.
There are fried avocado bites.
Oh, are they?
Ouch.
What did you say?
Ouch. Like if a fried avocado beat you.
Ouch. I don't get it.
What are those green bruises all over your arm? Oh, those are fried avocado bites.
That's not funny.
Avocado 17?
No. Marcia.
What? What?
Are you gonna actually eat anything?
I'm sorry, I wasn't listening.
I asked you if you were going to order anything this time.
When?
Now, for lunch.
I don't know. Sure, maybe.
Really?
Maybe. I don't know. Possibly. Probably not.
Oh, come on.
What?
Why did we come here?
It was close to the office.
You do this to me every week. You ask me to meet you for lunch, I say fine. You ask me to meet you at a restaurant, I say fine. And then we get here, I order lunch, you watch me eat, and you just drink an ice water.
Oh. Can I get an ice
water? No, you cannot have an ice water. Why are we here?
I thought you wanted to have lunch.
I do want to have lunch.
Then I brought you to a place where there is lunch.
But if you do not want lunch, we can go somewhere else. You know, I can sit in my car and eat a yogurt, and we can go anywhere where the purpose is not to have lunch. You get what I'm saying?
Sort of.
I mean, listen, we can go to the mall. Or to the library, or the museum. Ooh, my house was sculpture. We could go to the park. We could go anywhere where they're not serving food.
I guess.
But you insist on bringing me to a restaurant every week and you don't eat. It's bizarre.
It's not that bizarre.
Oh, it is. Are you sick? Are you unwell?
No, that's not it.
Because I've seen you eat a lot. That Marjorie Bunt's birthday thing in the break room, I watched you power through half a key lime pie with chopsticks. Oh, I know what you're capable of.
Key lime pie is my favorite.
Was it a psychological thing? Like a post-COVID thing or it's afraid to eat in public kind of thing?
No,
it's not. Are you on a diet?
God, no.
Oh, thank God, because the last time you were on a diet, you made me eat 4 different flavors of tofu puffs. And now every time I walk down the health aisle, oh my God, I get, you know, the PTSD-induced flashbacks.
Oh, it wasn't that bad.
Oh, barbecue ranch tofu puffs are bad, Marcia. They are objectively bad. They're the frackin' of snacking.
That rough?
Is it me? Am I gross?
No.
Do I spit food?
No.
Do I have kale stuck in between my teeth and lose your appetite watching me work it out with my tongue?
No, it is not you.
What is it? Why? Tell me, I'm developing this complex here and I have a rash on my arm and I think it might be thrush. I'm blaming you for it.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Don't be sorry. Just be honest. Why do we come to a different restaurant every week where I end up eating alone and you just watch me eat? Tell me I'm gonna key your car.
All right, I will tell you.
Now, Marcia.
I will. First, you need to know that I eat before I come.
You eat before you come? To the restaurant? Were you invited?
Yes.
You eat food?
Yes.
What do you eat?
I don't know. Whatever Lewis makes me for lunch.
Lewis makes you lunch?
Yes, every day. Yes.
He's your building super.
He is super at making sandwiches. So I eat before I come.
Well, why in heaven's earth are we here?
Well, I don't come for the food. I come for the menu.
Oh, no. The menu?
Yes.
You come to a different restaurant every week just so you can hold a menu?
Not just hold it, but yes.
Oh, not just hold it. Read. You come so you can read the menu.
Yes.
Ah, okay. Why on earth are you reading a menu?
Oh, Dawn. You wouldn't understand.
Oh, I mean.
Okay, look.
What?
Look at the menu, look.
What? They have vegan wings.
And what else?
And sweet potato tots.
And what else?
I don't know. Fish cobblers and nachos and chicken and, oh, is that chili? They have chili?
They do.
Oh, I love chili.
I know.
Oh my gosh, they have chili. I'm gonna have the brisket chili. Oh, that sounds so great.
It does sound great. It always great.
Oh, you've been here before.
Never.
What is wrong with you?
Every day we wake up and we get a shower, we brush our teeth, we wash our face, we kiss our loved ones on the cheek, and then we go to an office and we type and we call, we write, we meet, we gossip, and we kill ourselves to get to 5 o'clock if we're lucky. And then we go home and we make dinner, we do the dishes, we play with the babies, we feed the cats, and then we kiss our loved ones on the cheek and we pass out until the next morning when we do it all over again. No, it's one direction, Dawn. We're moving in one direction. Over and over and over on a loop. Groundhog Day, right? The movie where the guy he wakes up at the same time in the same place every day. We are living that. You, me, everyone we know. But a menu. Oh, it is a menu, Dawn. A menu is all about choice. It is all about options. Every road taken is a road not taken. Every item on this menu is an opening door. Every menu is a gateway to the future. I mean, you order the ribs and you win the lottery. You order the brisket and you meet the man of your dreams. You order this corn muffin and you discover that you are a princess from a small island nation off the coast of Italy. And you go there, you live in a castle, there's footmen, there's a woman who scrubs under your fingernails so you don't have to.
Or you order the fries and you get hit by a car.
Exactly! That's what I'm saying. That all of these options are... I come here and I look at these menus. And I think about the possibilities, Dawn, and I wonder about the path that I might take. And it is so beautiful. You know, it's just beautiful.
And it's also terrifying.
Because sometimes beauty and terror, they are the same thing. I think somebody's chopping onions.
Yeah, but you don't order anything. You don't eat anything. I mean, all those roads and none taken.
Of course not. How could I possibly? I wouldn't dare.
Why not?
How would I know which one is the right one? How would I possibly know which item is going to lead me to happiness?
Oh, it's a salmon. I don't know. He's like, this is insane, Marcia.
No. All of these options are different possible lives, Dawn. You know, they're different places to be. And if you... We look at these menu items. And I just dream about what they could be. What those possibilities are, yes. And how can I possibly know, right? I mean, if you order the ribs, it could lead to something terrible. If you order the empanada, it could lead to catastrophe. You order that California salad, and all those ribs, I mean, it could lead to the end of life if you know it.
Then you order something else.
No, because they're not just ribs, right? If I choose the ribs, I get back to the office 10 minutes later. And then I miss my deadline for the report I have to submit, and then I feel guilty, so I stay overtime, and then I hit traffic, and then when I finally do make it home, Lewis is not waiting for me any longer. He's gone back to his wife in Toledo, but he would have stayed if I had been there to profess my love for him, but now he's gone, and I am all alone except for the expiring Hulu subscription that I have, and then the goldfish is starved to death. There's that leaky faucet. Now no one's coming to fix that. And there's no food in the fridge except for the ribs from the lunch that destroyed the world.
So order something else.
I cannot
you
take that chance.
Can.
I can't. I would rather just sit here and look at these menu items and
think about them and dream about them and wonder and be very still and be quiet and keep living.
Marcia, honey, you cannot live your life terrified of making one wrong choice.
Okay.
No, you cannot screw it.
But why not?
Well, because every choice is the wrong choice. Or the right one. It's not just menus. It's the waking up and the going to work and the toothbrushing and the eating a sandwich that Louis the super made for you. Those are all choices, Marcia. Yeah, doing the dishes, not doing the dishes, only doing some of the dishes. Listen, and you can change those behaviors any given day and the outcome will be completely different from what you've experienced before. There's no right choice. There's no wrong choice. You've already taken the role that you never even knew that you could take.
Oh my God.
Yeah?
You are right.
Listen, your entire life is full of menus, Marcia. The movies you watch on TV, the roles that you turn down, the traffic laws that you obey, the clothes that you're wearing, everything affects everything else, and there's no way to predict what could come after the other.
You are so right.
I know.
I need to stop doing everything.
No. Oh my God. No, you can't.
Yeah,
you
I need to stop doing all of the things. I'm gonna stop waking up.
Stop getting out of bed. I'll quit my job. I will sell my car. No, I will give the car away. It's a Buick. No one's gonna buy a Buick.
You cannot stop doing everything.
I can. I can and I will. I will lie very still with my hands by my side and I will do as little as possible. And then I'll stop blinking. I will stop sneezing, but I'll hold my breath for as long as I possibly can, which is pretty long. I used to swim.
You can't.
I can and I will. No more anything from me. The endless possibilities are simply too terrifying to contemplate.
Marcia, what are you doing? Oh my God! Get your head off the table. We are in public. Okay. You're just gonna be here at the 1911 Smokehouse Barbecue Restaurant for the rest of your life. Or when they lock up, it's gonna leave you here. Okay, and you will die here from hunger or stupidity or whatever. This is ridiculous.
It's the only way.
Marcia. Okay, I see. You do know that you just made a choice, right? This right here, right now, was a massive choice. One that will affect everything that comes after it, and you don't know, I mean, I certainly don't, how it will go from here. You might touch people on this table.
Yay.
Or, someone might mistake you for a chicken and season you with salt and pepper and decide to eat you.
They would not dare.
Oh, you don't know. No one could ever know.
I do not want to be eaten like a chicken.
Well, if you stop doing everything, you can't prevent it.
Well, what am I supposed to do?
You make choices, Marcia. You make good choices. Okay, one that can predict the future by a little bit, not a lot. And you make good choices one after the other. And choices that make you happy the moment you're in, and choices that don't make you happy forever. Listen, you know, you'll find out that even if something does go terribly wrong, that you've experienced with a wealth of joy right up until the moment is gone.
Just choosing small moments of happiness.
One after the other, after the other.
Listen,
let's start with this. Okay. What on that menu makes you the happiest?
Oh. Fried avocado bites.
Ouch. That's a good choice.
Is it?
Well, we don't know, Marcia. We don't know.
My name is C. I'm from Art Pride, the people that presented this tonight. And unlike these professionals, I do need to read from a text. So ArtPride not only brings you these fun events, but we also advocate for the arts in New Jersey. So when COVID came around, we got federal funding, we doubled the state funding, and we kept the creative sector alive in New Jersey. But we also have something called jerseyarts.com. It's a website. That's my role at ArtPride. I send out writers and podcasters and videographers to cover previews of the arts in the state. So you get a little taste of what's going on, you get a little bit of the backstory, and we hope you gain awareness and participate in the arts in the state. So thank you very much for coming out. Luce, you've been to Passage Theater here before? Yeah, it's literally just down the street. It's as cute as a button. We hope you'll come out to see it. Thank you very much.
And there's no parking.